you will have your quest, you will have your search, and that is what will sustain you more than anything. That's your ultimate source of wealth.
I feel like it's hard trying to make people see what you see. It's hard to get them to see your own perspective.
You know, this is what I really think. When you see me, you're like, oh, he doesn't think like that. You know, I look different than what I think.
One of the hardest things about being in college is just being alone in New York City.
I believe that I could make people change their minds, become a superhero.
I was also thinking that it was always somebody else's fault if I wasn't happy.
The metaphor of the cave says that we are all prisoners in the cave, looking at shadows dancing on the wall, and think that that's all there is. One day, one prisoner finds that his or her chains are loose. They stand up, and they turn around, and they realize that what made the shadows on the back of the cave wall was, in fact, this bright, blinding light coming into the cave mouth. So I'm making a movie about what happens to people when they learn, how it changes them, what they leave behind, what are they going towards? Not just a diploma, but this whole big picture. Who are they going to be in the future?
The first time I came across Plato's allegory of a cave was in my first semester here at Lehman. I read it and I understood it and I thought it was enlightening. You know, when you read something the second time, it kind of hits you harder. It just was like this light bulb that went off in my head.
Right now, I am in college. I am about to graduate. If I were to reference myself in terms of Plato's cave, I would say that I'm continuously blinking in that light. No one actually really told me how hard it is to go to college, study, go to class, go to work. You get back home and you're just exhausted. I want to get to the point where I'm not going to be blinking in the light. I want to feel more stable.
I have to make a decision. Am I going to go towards this light or not? Or am I going to go sit back down with my friends?
I'm almost 19 now. I meet people, like I try to see, you know, if they're genuinely good. I'm outgrowing some of my friends and that kind of hurts. It really doesn't matter where you go to college. Like, some people are harped on, oh, you know, I gotta go to Georgetown, I gotta get into Harvard. But you could go to a city university, get a great education, and if you get great grades, you could go anywhere.
Each class, each professor offers something new to me, you know, open a new opportunity, open a new door to new thoughts. A moment where my life completely changed was when I left Columbia at the age of 8 and I moved to the United States to reunite with my mom. I left all my family. I came to a new place where I didn't know the language.
I realized that there was an enormous world out there, and there's this huge sun. Wow.
The learning process isn't only in the classroom, it's also what you see around you. Living in a town that only has about 4,500 people isn't the same as living in New York City. Everyone has a very closed-minded perspective as to what the world is and how the world works, and New York is different.
Living in Pakistan, you're kind of in a cave. There's just like this set lifestyle there.
We had to step back and check what is it that we're doing, what are we saying, what are we thinking, and how that is in fact affecting us in our daily lives.
I am discovering that the world is much more complicated, and that in my mind, certainty is not much of a virtue, but more like a defect. You just become slave to conventions.
Keeping true to my roots and some traditions, but at the same time walking with the world.
I am struggling a lot, but I'm trying to make it to somewhere one day when I graduate.
I want people to hear my name and either be inspired or be fearful.
There are those who do believe in God for the wrong reasons. They believe in God because they don't want to believe that there isn't something. If you're going to believe in something, believe it because you think you believe it, not because you're just like, I'm scared. I want it to be there.
What's wrong with you? This is reality. These shadows on the wall.
All right, I'm Gregory Spiliotis.
I am Lisa Marie Blanco.
Hi, my name is Maha Musker.
My name is Melissa Garcia Velez.
My country of origin is Greece, England, France, and Ireland.
And I'm from Pakistan.
I'm from Colombia.
My name is Percy Luham, and I don't know anything.
I see myself helping people, allowing them to live a new life, and offering them what I've been offered in this country.
Right now, where are you in Plato's cave.